lining changes everything.
I will show you how just one 3D model can look completely different using 3 lining setup. Let's level up your render using only light. We will be using this wireless mouse model and explore how different lining style create different modes. No modeling today, just lining setup only, and let's get started. If you enjoy Blender tutorial on modeling, lining, animation, and product visualization, you are in the right place. Now you can become a channel member and unlock exclusive perks like early access to all my tutorial video. And the best part, at the end of each month, you will get a complete Blend file pack containing all the project file from every tutorial released that month. Just hit the join button below to become a member and support this channel to grow. Okay, that's all. Let's start the tutorial.
I'll give you free Blend file, so you can easily follow along. Link download in the description below. But if you wanted to know how I'm modeling this mouse, you can check out my previous video. This is my setup for the soft light, the studio light. This setup works great for tech product and e-commerce style render. We are using a large soft key light from above, soft light on the both side, and a simple white or gray backdrop. Let me disable the light. This big area light become our main light, and this two other light is just to fill the dark side part. And we can actually delete this one, and let's disable this one. Let's put it here. Press S to scale it on the Y axis, then increase the power. Yep, something like this. It's probably enough. Just to create only with one area light, it just feels like enough to create the soft light or like a studio light. We can add another light. Okay, that's all. And this lining setup also works for the other product like I'm using over here. Let me adjust the camera. The product looks just pretty fine. Let's move to the next one. The second one, it's kind of dramatic-like. This setup uses a single hard light from the side and a strong rim light from separation with every little fill. Let's break down this. Press H and we can increase the power if you wanted to. I think the point of the dramatic light here, you need a shadow, a lot of shadow. And the second light, just to show a little bit for the shape of your product. And this dramatic light also works with another kind of product. Here's the 3 render sample with different light position. And this 3 render sample for other product. Let's move to another. And the last part is maybe kind of cinematic light. Let's enable the render view. Okay. As you can see here, I'm using like 4 area light. Let's break it down one by one. The first one here, it should be the main one. It's light up the product and the background here. You can change the shape, disc or square, anything you want, but I will love to use disc. And you can change the color. I'm going like this. And for this one, the back over here, I'm using a different color to give a visual strong contrast. It make it looks like futuristic and stylish. And let's see the other. And this area light, it's only like the edge of our product. Let me disable this one and enable this. As you can see, this edge didn't look pretty well, so I add another light. You can see the difference. Okay, but this light, let's go to the object property. It's only like the product, not the background. Let me hide this. As you can see, this area light didn't affect the background. I'm just using linking shadow here. Let me disable this one. Okay, now this light is like the object and the background also. When we create new here, then let's click and drag our background. Let's move it here. When this one is enabled, the area light only light the background. And let's disable it. It didn't light up the background, but only light the product. Okay, and the last one, this light, it's only to give a blue light on the side over here. Just look at over here, when we disable it, it's only give a light to this area. That's all. Here's the 3 render sample with different light position. And this 3 render sample for other product. Let me know your favorite in the comment.
like this video if it helped you out, and share it with a fellow Blender user. Don't forget to subscribe for another tutorial. Thank you for watching, and see you on my next video.